Hello everybody, we are here for another video this morning. Today is Destruction Day, although slight change of plans. James actually has a snow day today, so he doesn't have school. So I didn't feel like making him get up at the oh dark 30 this morning to make a video with me. Let him sleep in and enjoy it, right? So, what I'm going to be doing is I will show you my destruction world. I've got one that I do on my own, and here it is. I do have one main goal that I need to do today. See, I've got this one picket. Oh, and you'll know. So I have an above ground base kind of here-ish, I guess. I don't have a house anywhere. But this is kind of my above ground base because this is the corner of the world where right over here is the stairs to go down to my base under the world. So again, the goal is the same as the world that James and I are doing, to totally destruct a old map size world, which I believe is 256 by 256 by 256. So this has kind of become my base, since those are the stairs to the work I've been doing underground. This was kind of a medium size hill over in this corner, which obviously is totally flat now, but it was probably 8 or 10 blocks high all the way over to here, which is, that was a river that I've drained so far. This is more drained river right here, all this grass. I used dirt to do it, and then I also used sand for part of it. But at this point I had run out of sand, so just used dirt. I had a garden because I had a cow pen there so that I could have never-ending leather. But then I had enough that I got enough that I don't need to worry about it anymore, and that's one of the things that got broken down when I was doing my destruction. So let's go. I'll start with a fresh day. I'll give you a tour above ground, and then the goal that I want to accomplish today is below ground, so we'll go there last. So we'll go up here first. So my pickaxe has mending on it, so I need XP to actually mend it. So I'm gonna, there's some places that have coal up here that I'm gonna dig up today, hopefully get a little XP that way. Okay, so this area here, I actually, over here I use some TNT to break up some of it. That's why it's all crazy looking. I don't usually do too much with TNT, but I've found that when I need mending, I tend to stay up at night and kill monsters and stuff, so I usually get a lot of gunpowder from killing creepers. Okay, so here's the top of this mountain. As you can see in my destruction world, I was quote unquote lucky enough to get extreme hills biomes to use to do my destruction world. It wasn't like the one James and I are doing where Everything is kind of low, and we don't really have any mountains higher than 10 or 15, maybe 20 blocks. But this mountain used to be as high as those over there. And I've got it down to two different flat areas. This one's almost as low as that one. What is that, 3 blocks? Nope, 2 blocks. Getting closer. And I guess my preferred method is just kind of make the sides like little steps going all the way up. So then no matter whenever I want to work on any part of it, I can just go to any side and jump up to the top and start working. And it looks kind of cool, you know, because it gives it a little bit of a pyramid shape when you're doing it. So my current place, when I work on this mountain, my current place I've been working on is over here on this side. Oh, bunch of stuff left over from when I was working on it last. So I've been working on cutting steps into this side of it. So quite a bit of work left in front of me. Each one of these sides to make a step probably takes about 10 minutes per level. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's probably another hour and a half worth of work to get that done. That's a lot of work. Oh, one other thing real quick. So, you know how when you die in Minecraft, if your bed blows up, then you lose your spawn point. So what I've done is you'll notice that I have beds all over the place. So what I did is I made a whole bunch of beds and have them at least at every corner. Oh, shoot, I need food. Well, we'll have to take care of that this next corner. So I have beds at every corner. So whenever it's nighttime, I always have someplace close I can sleep without having to worry about my bed being blown up by a creeper or having my bed on me when I'm dying. If I die, then you know I just respawn at the last place I slept. So yeah. See, here's more extreme hills. There's another hill over here that I've been working on right there. That one was kind of annoying because it was tall enough it was snow covered. So I had to deal with a whole bunch of snowballs. Either I had to use a shovel and get snowballs, or I had to use my pickaxe or my hand or fist or something and break up a bunch of snow very slowly, and that wasn't working for me. Oh yeah, see here, it's 40 leather, so I've got plenty of leather now. I don't need to worry about that. Bunch of bows. Gotta be food here somewhere. Where's the food? I was hoping for cooked food. Oh, right there, pork chops. 9 pork chops. Good. I will replace you with that. And I'll replace you with some of this stuff. This looks like a good place for you. See, there's a whole bunch of snowballs. That's what I've been having to deal with. So these chests, not really so much organization, but I do have a goal for them and what I'm gonna do. Oh yeah, so hold on, let's eat. There we go. Oh yeah, as you can see, that. Oh yeah. Here's a little hidey hole that I used to use when I was going away from the game for a little bit. I would leave myself in here so that my sugar cane would grow. Because if I went too far away, obviously it wouldn't grow. Oh, and look, creeper in my boat. So that's nice. Hmm. Hi. Please don't blow up. You did! What? You just blew up my boat. You shouldn't have been able to see me. You turd burglar. Nuggets. Oh, whoa, check that out. A wolf is attacking a llama. I had no idea they would do that. That poor llama. You big bully. Sheesh. Alright, so those are really the only two big places that I've been doing a lot of work, because those are the places that had the biggest mountains. That one up there, not really much to show there. Maybe I'll make another video sometime and show you that. But for now, I want to get down underground and take care of what I was coming to do. So, yep. This is how high this used to be. Cut a path too deep all the way down. I think before too long, my goal right now is I need to get my mending pickaxe full again. Obviously, you can see that's quite a bit of work. But once I get that back, I'm gonna work on digging away these two layers around here. Because I think it would look really cool if my next step was to get those two layers dug all the way down to bedrock. So that will be it. Hey, look at you. What? Thank you for the XP for my pickaxe. Yeah, so there's not a whole lot going on here either, just more ground. Used that place as a little farm for birch trees, so I could have a never-ending source of wood. And, oh, here's another bed, so let's sleep since it's getting dark. See how handy that is? We're running around, it's getting dark, so... There's a bed, so let's see. Oh, there's another creeper. I just saw his head over here. Let's go kill him and get some XP. Oh! Okay. 16 never hurt anybody. Let's go. Alright. So, here we go. Back to the beginning. Here's the... Oh, there's another bed. Crafting table. Chest. Pretty sure that wasn't like that. How did that happen? That was on ground that was there. I definitely would have cut that down. I'm gonna leave that there because it's interesting. Okay. So, oh, look, pork chops for free. Thank you, wolf. No. We don't want that where bad guys can get up in my world. That's why this trench is two blocks deep all over the place. Keep the bad guys out. Alright, let's go down below. Okay. So here we are. I have these two levels, so I think the last one with any bedrock on, I think layer one is all bedrock, layer two is mostly bedrock, layer three is some bedrock, and the first one above it is four. So this would be layers four and five that I have dug out. Enchanting, and a whole bunch of chests that don't really do anything yet, although this one has a bunch of enchanting books that I've either enchanted with by putting books in the enchanting table or that I caught fishing. I don't think any of these other chests have anything in them yet. So the cool thing about this area down here is that it's a good place for slimes. So I've had a bunch of slimes that spawned, and I've got 15 stacks of slime blocks and almost 6 more stacks of slime balls, and then all the slime blocks I put in the ground here. My niece helped me with that one time, but it slows you down when you're walking. I'm not really sure I like this idea, so I think long term, I think there's going to be something else that I come up with to do with those. But my goal today, what I need to do is kill a bunch of slimes and get XP back for my... I don't need knockback or looting or anything for slimes. I already have enough slime balls, so I don't need extra ones because of looting. So we'll go run around and find some slimes and kill them and take the XP for my mending pickaxe. Oh, so you might notice these are lapis lazuli blocks. I'll go to the middle and I'll tell you the significance of those. Oh, there's some slimes. Good. For a second, I was a little worried that they weren't going to be spawning here anymore. Oh, there's a big one. Now, a lot of people think slimes are annoying, and they can be, but what I like about them is they're a great source of XP. Oh, yeah, that's right. So in case you didn't know, how mending works is the XP that you get from killing things or cooking things in a furnace or anything else goes to mending your pickaxe or mending whatever tool it is you have that has mending on it. Or you can also get mending on armor, so it would always keep your armor full. You just if it's on a tool like this, you just have to have the tool in your hand, not when you kill whatever you're getting the XP for, but whenever the XP gets to you. Okay, so if I like use the sword and stop missing, there you go. Okay, see how the XP isn't to me yet? Now I can switch to my sword and get the XP, and it goes to mending my sword instead of increasing my level, which you can see is level 12. But the reason I used my pickaxe the first time when I was killing that big slime is that it's just too hard when you have all those slimes around to kill them with your sword and then switch back to your pickaxe every time. So I just use my pickaxe to kill those. Okay, so here we are at the middle. The different paths I have here, so I have three redstone paths and one lapis. They all go all the way out to the corners. And the theory behind that is I wanted a way, if I was in the middle, I wanted a way of knowing which corner my base was at. So I wouldn't just have to run around the whole thing. And I was getting all the lapis and redstone. Anyway, so I just made blocks out of them and used them to make paths so that if I'm running around here killing slimes like I am right now, I'm like, okay, well, this is redstone, that's not the right way. Let's go to the middle and oh, lapis, that's the way I need to go. Oh, there's another slime. Yeah. So it just makes it easier when I'm out killing slimes, so I don't have to guess which way I need to go. Give me your XP. I am your father. I'm not really their father. I'm just sounding funny. Oh yeah, in case you didn't know it, small slimes can't hurt you. Only the really big ones and the middle-sized ones can hurt you. And they don't really do that much damage. Although I do have full diamond armor, so that might help. But they still don't do a whole lot. Hey, look at that. The top row of my head gets cut off in the stone. Okay, enough fooling around. I need to find slimes. You can see my mending pickaxe has increased a little bit, the red line. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Come on, slimes. So before too long, it's going to be time to dig around the next two levels in the bottom here. If for no other reason, then it's just going to be time. So I need more diamonds. I'm running out of diamonds. I'll go show you my diamond stash. It's getting kind of low. Now, I took one stack up to the surface. But that really depleted my diamond stash down here. I mean, I'm close to running out. I've only got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stacks of diamonds. I mean, that's close. I had so much iron, I had to start making blocks. Gold. I'm keeping the gold because eventually I want to do something with a minecart. I want to make a minecart system underground somehow. I think that might be, you know, once I get the, you know, I told you I wanted to get the two layers, or the two rows all the way around the edge of the world broken down. Maybe once I get those broken down, I'm thinking I might make a minecart track going to get up the world from there, so that I don't have, so that I have a way up and down, because at that point I'll either have to leave the stairs on one side or come up with something else, and I just think a minecart track would be pretty cool. So we'll have to see. But this life doesn't seem to be spawning much anymore. But it is about time for me to call it a day, or at least a video. Maybe I'll call it a Minecraft day. And I will get going, and I hope you enjoy the video. Let me know if you have any questions. I'm sure there's a lot of tips or tricks or something that you may have seen that I did here that I didn't mention. But if you do have any, let me know. Oh, just one more thing about my chest layout. This is kind of my base here with these chests on top, and then starting with this one is food, and then these are all miscellaneous stuff, torches, slime, etc. But in every corner of the world, there's a small chest for dirt, because I didn't figure, hey, there wouldn't be too much dirt at the bottom of the world. And then there's gravel and andesite to one side, and granite and diorite to the other. And then all the other chests, all cobblestone. I don't know how many chests I have here. The cobblestone are full. Oh yeah. So then I did every 10 chests. I left a little break so that I could have a little path into the outer world, I call it, in my head. Because I always knew I was going to expand. So that'll give me a way through into the other part of the world. Oh, that's gravel. Okay, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 chests of cobblestone. And to be honest, each corner of the world is probably about the same. I have way more chests than I used, but my destruction isn't done either. I've got a bunch of destruction I'm going to do on levels way above this. So anyway, that's my world. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you have any questions or comments or ideas, feel free to leave them in the comments. Thanks. Bye.